Assalamualaikum and a very good day to you all. In this video, I would like to start with the first miscellaneous questions for Mathematics of Finance. So, after winning a singing competition, Danish decides to invest half of the prize money, okay, to Bank Astro for 10 years. And the bank offers three options for him to save his money based on the following table. Okay, so the first one, option A, is giving a simple interest rate of 4%, and B, a simple discount rate, and C, compounded quarterly. As we can see, all the number are the same, 4%. It's just the different kind of rates that the bank offers. Okay, so the first one, the question asks us to find the accumulated amount at the end of the term for each option. So for A, to answer the first question, first thing first, he is not deposit the money, all the money that he won. Okay, so he only wants to deposit half of it. So 1,000 ringgit multiplied by half is 50,000. Okay, so this is the money that he's going to use. In short, this is our P. Okay, so for option A, okay, for option A is a simple interest rate. So the simple amount or the future value in simple interest rate is just the P, okay, and then 1 + 0.04, how many years? 10 years. Okay, and then if you use your beloved calculator, you will get 70,000. Okay, and then let's move on to the second option. Okay, now for simple discount rate, it's a D, small d. Interest rate, it's an R, and compounded quarterly is a J. Okay, when we have a J, don't forget we must find the TMJ. Yeah, okay. Okay, so for B, okay, simple discount rate. So what we are going to find is the 50,000 over here. 50,000 is the proceed, okay, and then S is the face value. Okay, so 1 - 0.04, the simple discount rate, and then for 10 years. Okay, and then you use your calculator. Okay, you should get 83,333.33. Yeah, okay, and then the last option is option C, compounded quarterly. I just said if you see compounded over here, it must involve J. J is 0.04, we must get TMJ. T is 10 and M is compounded quarterly over here. Quarterly. Okay, what does it mean by quarterly? Quarterly means one quarter in a year, there are four quarters, so there are four times in a year. If an interest rate is if interest is calculated quarterly in a year, there will be four times lah. That's why the M is four, and then the future value is 50k multiplied by 1 + I is J over M, 0.04 divides by 4. And then 4 multiplied by 10. Okay, and then you should get your future value is 74,443.19. Okay, so that's the first part. Okay, now let's answer B, total interest or discount gain for the best option. Okay, so total interest or discount gain for the best option. Okay, so from here, from A, B, and C, since this is a saving, since it's about investment, so we must have the highest return. And as we can see, the highest return is when Danish chose option B. Okay, so the total interest gain from that one is, the interest is just substitute 50,000 out of the 83,333.33 ringgit. Okay, and then we have the answer. So 53, 55, sorry. 53, 53, apa? 33, sorry. 33 cent. Okay, so that is the answer. Okay, I think that's all. You can watch for the next video, for the second, for the next question. Thank you for your time and attention. Assalamualaikum. Have a good day.